Hey everyone, Playground AI just got another update. They added GPT-4o. So now you have GPT-4o and Playground version 3. I'm going to show you the difference in this video and some of the new features that came with this update. So let's go into Playground AI right now and I'll show you all the changes. All right, so here we are on Playground. You can see it didn't change that much on the homepage, so that's great. You don't have to learn anything new here, but I'm gonna show you the differences. So typically we start with t-shirt, but of course you can do any one of these. So I'm gonna start here and then we can pick any one of these. So I'm gonna just pick this one right here, Camping Life. Now, when we look at this, we can see down here has changed. So this is the different part right here. So you can see choose model, PG version 3, which is Playground version 3, which they've had before. But if you click on here, you can also see 4.0. So this is GPT-4.0. And you can see the differences right away. They kind of tell you GPT-4.0 is high quality and precise editing. So you'll get nicer pictures with this, especially if you want photorealistic stuff. And then Playground version 3, it has great images, but it's a lot faster. So that's the speed. And they'll give you more images. So in this case, when we did Playground version 3, we got four different ones. In 4.0 image, you'll just get one at a time. So we'll do 4.0 right here. And then you can change this thing right here, just like you do. So you can hit describe your text. So let's say what we want to change in here. So I'm just going to type this in. So I put change illustrations and words to reflect beach life. I'm going to make more specific, change camping life to beach life. All right, so I just made this more specific, change words to beach life too. So just in case I didn't understand. And then I'm going to hit this arrow up here and you're going to see that it's going to take a while. Now, GPT-4 takes a little longer, like it said, with than PGV3 or Playground version 3, but I'm not going to have you wait here. I'm just going to speed this up and then show you the results. There you go. So here's the results. Really cool. I like the look. It kept the watercolor and everything and very nice, and it changed the words to beach life, and I love the colors and everything. You can still do some changes here. If you want to add an image, we're going to do that in another one. But now that we're in V or 4.0, you have some different things here as well. So you can change the style. And this is new to 4.0. The styles are different in Playground version 3. But I like this. It's kind of a visual representation of what the style is. So I don't know. Let's try and pick one. Let's see. There's one already that's Camping Life. But what if we pick this one here? You can see you can just change on the fly. So you can see it picked a totally different style, different colors and everything. It kind of went off the board here, but let's see, what is this? Oh, if it did do something, you can actually report the issue. So one thing that I like trying out is I'm going to try and resize this. And instead of 1x1, I'm going to do 2x3. And I think sometimes that works. So pretty cool. And then so there it is, different styles. Now it's all in there. And I can also try and go to Playground 4.3. So you can use these interchangeably and then change the style as well. This is some of the different styles that 4.3 has, or version 3 has, and I can change it to this. Pretty cool, right? So you can see what I really like about Playground is that you can go back and see like where it did these changes. So if I like this better, I can still stick with this and download this, or I could take a detour and change this to a different style and go that way. So you can see the progression here, and this is really cool as well. So I'm gonna show you some other features that this does that came with the new update. So I'm gonna go back to Playground here, and we're gonna start with a sticker this time. And in stickers, I'm just gonna, well, I didn't have to do this. I could have searched with everything. Let me go back. I'm just gonna search for a dog. So to show you reference. So one of the cool things is that you can use a reference. So I'm gonna do this cool dog right here, right? And then, I'm guessing this is a Labrador, but I want it to be a corgi. So what I did was I found a corgi online. So let me show you what I'm gonna do with the 4.0 image. So we're on 4.0 again. This only works at 4.0. I can add the image with this plus button and pick the corgi that I want here. And so you can see it's a regular corgi. It's a photo of a corgi from the internet right here. And then I'm just gonna say change the dog to the dog in the attached photo. That's it. And there we go. So let's see what it does. It should take the reference photo and then just change the dog in the same style, which is pretty cool. So there you go. Check that out. So I have a corgi now. So this is what it was before. And now this is it because of the style that I put in there. Now, of course, I can continue to do and change things with it. I can also go back to Playground 4.3 and change the words on it. So I can do this and then just say change words to cool corgi. I don't know. That's not trending, but let's see. Let's just check how it does it. Now, see, in Playground version 3, I get four choices, and it's a little faster, and I can pick which one is the best one out of these. There you go. It added not exactly the same picture as the other one, but it changed the words. Pretty cool. So if I don't like that, I can always go back and say I want to keep this one and see what it does with the 4.0 model and say change to cool corgi. There you go. So in 4.0, it did a little bit different. It added that, and it still has the cool corgi. And you still can do style, right? Change the style. And you notice these styles are a little bit different because they're the sticker styles than the one that I had with the t-shirt styles, because this is a sticker. You can see the white outline. You can resize again, and then you can also do the color preset. So I'll show you that in a little bit, but still has all of that in 4.0. I wanted to show you one more thing. So I'm gonna go back to Playground here, and this is with Create. So let's say you're stuck for an idea. You have some ideas that are working, but maybe want to change it and do something different. So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna start here, not with one of these, but I'm gonna start by uploading and editing an image. So now, when you upload an image, let's say I have my Catacorn image, it just brings it in like this. So this is your starting point. And then you can just write a prompt from this and then change these things. So here's the prompt that I'm gonna use. So I'm gonna do change the cat to a raccoon since raccoons are super popular right now. I'm not sure why, but they are. And then I'm gonna use 4.0, and then that's it. I'm gonna hit this and see what it does. So it should keep the same style that I have on here, which is that kawaii style, and the same colors, but just change out the cat and make it a raccoon unicorn or whatever it comes up with. So we'll see. I should have said keep it as a unicorn, but let's see if it's smart enough to keep that horn in there. There it is. So it kept even the same style letters, raccoon, and voila, that's pretty cool, right? So I'm gonna try and change it again to another style, picking from here. So let's see what it does with this style, which is totally different, and let's see what GPT-4o does with it. Wow, there you go. So different style. I can also go back if it gets cut off. I can go back and maybe try it with a different size right here, or I could try it with Playground 3 and then change the style as well. Let's try something cool here. Really like this frolic one. And look at that. Still really cool with Playground version 3. So that's what I like about these is that you can go back. Now when I go forward, it doesn't have that other one. So it kind of changed course corrected. So these new updates are super versatile. It can help you with so many things. You can use references. You can start with your own stuff and then change it. and come up with different ideas. You can see what I started with was totally different, magical catacorn. Then I came to magical raccoon, which I think is still pretty cool. And then I changed that to a different style, raccoonicorn, and this is really cool. So I would even put this in my Detour shirt. So I think this can be really cool. So play around with it. That's what I love about Playground, that you can play around with it, no pun intended, but you can change the styles here. You can resize, you can change your color palette. And when you're done, you can export it, download this. There's more actions. Of course, you're gonna have to remove the background if you're not a pro member, but if you are a pro member, you can upscale and remove background, upscale it by 4 times, which is, you know, big enough. It's gonna be, instead of 1024, it's gonna be 498, I think, 496. Sorry, I can't do the math. And then remove the background, both. You can do these separately. So there you go. That's the updates for Playground. It keeps getting better and better. So I just want to go through the homepage one more time. One of the things that's really cool about Playground is when you come in here, there's all these different templates. So they know which one's coming up, like Mother's Day is coming up. So you can see what's trending on their site, what most people are using. You can see what's newly added to their site with this new button. You can also go to Mother's Day templates if you're going to do Mother's Day, because that's the next holiday coming up, and all these different styles. You can also go to templates, which it remembers what you were doing. So it knows that I was doing the dog thing. So I'm like, maybe he likes more dogs. So here's all the dog templates. And these are all the ones that I just looked at. And here are some popular templates. And you know, Father's Day coming up, graduation's coming up, Easter and spring already passed, Mother's Day's coming up, and so on. So I like that you can brainstorm here, and it kind of gives you some ideas if you feel stuck. You can look at the templates and you can look at all those other things. So those are the new updates with GPT-4.0 and Playground. So there you go, that's Playground's update, GPT-4.0. I really like how the designs turned out, and I really like that you can go back and forth and play around with it. So many cool styles, so many cool things, and it just comes out great. The designs just look really cool, like that unicorn, the raccoonicorn that came out was really cool. If you want to try Playground, I'll put a link in the description for Playground so that you can try it out, play around with it. If you haven't seen my first video that I did with Playground, which is really cool, I'll put that link right here so you can see kind of the differences and the progression from when I first talked about it last month and how it's doing now. It's always changing and updating. Thanks again for watching, and as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.